Becca here. Thanks for coming out on Carol Night. These are our last performances of this whole calendar year at Washington and Brook Theater, and we're thrilled that you're here with us. We're in the middle of a one-year artistic residency here at the studio, and Carol Night is a program that we have been doing for 14-some years. So it was one of the first things that we were happy to bring back, and it's a program that's growing and growing. In fact, the next cycle of Carol teams starting in January, we'll be growing our program from 3 teams to 7 teams. So yeah, there's a lot of improvisers coming up in this community, and we're thrilled that you're here to enjoy them. Tonight you're going to see two teams perform, Monster and Vendetta. These are both teams that will be sunset in January, with some of their players moving on to other new teams. So these are some of the very last performances, not only of this calendar year, but of these teams as they exist. Is anybody here at an improv show for the very first time in your life? Fantastic, welcome, welcome. So what you probably already have figured out is that everything will be improvised. There's no script, there's no game plan. The players are listening to each other, maybe taking suggestions from you in the audience to create a show that's unique and will never be repeated again. So it's just for you. With that, are you ready to welcome our first team?
All right, let's give a warm
welcome to Monster!
She was like on a spring, and I would like play with it. And one time, I pulled it too hard, and she like hit the mirror, and her head broke off. And I was afraid to tell my mom.
When my sister was little, she really resented being given a bunch of Barbie dolls, and so she cut all their heads off and then just masqueraded their like decapitated bodies around her bed.
One of the times that I got the most trouble in my childhood was when I created a murder scene with my Barbie dolls, and I used. Nail polish to create the blood and mark up their face. I think I cut their faces. I didn't dismember any part off per se, but there was a full murder scene on my bedroom floor.
I remember that I believed in Santa for like an embarrassingly long time, and the year that I stopped believing in Santa was when it was really hard to get Furbies, and my mom was like, well, I don't know, like there might not be a Furby for you, and
I don't remember anything about being particularly in or not into things like to Santa, but I was obsessed with the Tooth Fairy. I wrote a lot of short stories in first grade and stuff about like meeting the Tooth Fairy, and it was like a thing that I was like so captivated. I wrote her all sorts of notes that were like, show me who you are, I won't tell anyone. And I also thought that I could be the Tooth Fairy, so I don't really know what I thought.
I was thinking about this the other day, that like it must be very stressful as a parent to have to sneak into your kid's room and like put money under their pillow for the Tooth Fairy. Like I can't think of many more stressful scenarios where you're like faced with this.
If you have a kid, the really important thing to do is always have noise going so that they don't wake up for anything. So my kid can sleep through like a jackhammer, he slept in airports at 2 a.m. in the morning. Like I've given him no comfort to his sleep, which made giving him Tooth Fairy money very easy. And even that was hard though, because you have to stay awake and get it to them. So one time I forgot. And he woke up and looked and he was really disappointed. And I was like, just go to the bathroom. And then I was like, oh no, I found it. It's all under the bed.
Another sister story. She was very eager about Christmas growing up. And so she would get up at like literally 5 a.m. because she was so excited for Christmas morning. And so my parents then begrudgingly would have to like wake up earlier and earlier every year as she just like had this little like arms race with them to like try to catch Santa and then, and yeah, we all went to jumping on our beds at 5 a.m.
$2 in shiny quarters here.
$2.
It's a really good two.
So I can get a two.
Well, look, look, look.
Oh. Oh no, Rosie.
I don't know why I did all of that. Just to prove
yeah.
that.
There's nothing there.
There's nothing there.
Where's my money?
My tooth worked hard for that.
I know. You were jiggling that thing for like a whole week before it came out.
It really hurt.
So I. Should
the
I
tooth
get...
is gone. Okay. Do you think the tooth fairy stole it?
No.
Without giving me the money?
She wouldn't do that. We know her. We've been doing business with her for years.
We have. But Tabitha, think about it. Do we know her?
I mean, I guess we've never seen her, but...
I feel like that's like a pretty important part of knowing someone.
Well, it's true. It's just that we've always... She's never done this before.
I don't know what to do. Like, I followed the system. Put the tooth under there.
Yeah.
I slept kind of like stage left of the
Because
I didn't want to end out. And then usually the money's right there. It's
yeah.
like four shiny quarters, but I thought since it was a molar.
Yeah.
Eight.
Right.
I'm very disappointed.
Well, it's gotta be here somewhere. I just don't think she would do that to us.
I really appreciate how invested you are in this. Twins really are like your other half.
Yeah. I don't want you to be disappointed. I don't want you to have had your money stolen either.
Huh. I really like that molar bag.
Yeah.
So I'd rather have the money. And teeth are kind of weird once they're like out.
Yeah, they get like crusty.
They're like small, they're like hard. And
yeah.
Sharp and I cut myself on one. Do you remember that?
Yeah. That was a weird time.
I guess being the tooth fairy is pretty hazardous. It's like teeth cutting, teeth, it's hard.
What if she died while she was in the
okay, so I used your Ken doll for a murder scene. Do you want to see him? He's dead.
You killed my Ken doll?
Yeah.
Ken doll or Ken doll?
Ken doll.
Sleeping on really great.
Is this like an acupressure thing?
Yeah, sure.
You don't look comfortable.
I'm fine. It's great.
Why don't you do it for a while? Let me know how it is.
the sensations in my back are interesting. And are you doing it?
I'm gonna go front seats. Now I'm doing it.
I'm gonna go front seats too, just so that I can see how it's going.
I feel like there's spikes going into my quads.
There are. It's good. It's like a massage technique. Are you ready for the next level?
No, but yeah.
It's gonna be great. I'm gonna turn on.
Why don't you describe it first before
I agree? I mean, that kind of ruins the fun of it all.
Okay, I trust you. You're always on the cutting edge.
I think we we play very loudly.
Yeah, Blair's right.
Blair.
I nailed it.
On my legs, right?
This is distracting me from what feels like knives going in.
If you can do this,
my bones.
You can sleep anywhere. You could be an astronaut. You could sleep in space. You can, be a discoverer and climb volcanoes and sleep. Like, this is gonna be great for us.
Yeah. And maybe I'm like economy plus on flights.
That's where that started.
And you were like, oh, come over to my house. I've got this whole like all these new things. Okay. So you're gonna blare some. What were you gonna play?
Some heavy metal.
Oh.
Like as loud as possible. You ready?
Don't tell mom and dad, but okay. untimely death, potentially murder.
Yeah.
Okay. I've been doing this for the last several weeks on the inner side of my window. I don't know, I saw it in a castle. It was a crime procedural that was on BBC for several years.
Oh.
It's fun. It's on Hulu. Anyway.
Oh, that is my list.
I connect.
Oh no!
I should be more upset.
Are you pickpocketing me?
The opposite.
Business meetings.
You're so different than what I expected.
That was kind.
I thought you would have a tiara and a flowing ethereal blue dress.
You know, what happened was, a few years ago, I did this for my nephew, and then everybody in the neighborhood just kept wanting me to do it. And it's my fifth job, and I can't keep it up anymore. And I forgot.
I'll just
Hi, walking through. Just, I'm sure that you're following all fiduciary and fiscal guidelines.
Yes,
and
you're my least favorite analyst.
Okay, well, that's really inappropriate to say in the workplace, but I'm going to set that aside because I know there's no way that you could be up to no good or plotting to create a financial crisis for your own gain.
We're not. And I just want you to know.
Let that go.
I don't even know. She's as innovative as a potato.
I heard that. I thought you left. And you know this whole potato thing that you're obsessed with? It's really mean. And potatoes can be a lot of different things. Vodka and french fries.
You're super distracted.
Good day.
I mean, you know, you didn't have to be so mean to Sarah.
I just called it like it was. Look, what really matters here is the financial fiasco that we're about to create and benefit from. Are you with me or not? I mean, do you want to be a kind of potato?
No, I don't want to be a kind of potato. You just listed all of their uses, and there weren't very many.
Right, exactly. So you're going
to
be
because I'm on my way back. I'm just going back to my office. I just wanted to mention that they can also be like scalloped or mashed.
She knows a lot about potatoes.
She's right.
She's right?
Yeah, they can be those things.
Are you buying into her?
I don't know, she's like our colleague. I'm just trying to give her the benefit of the doubt. I don't know. Hey, did you ever play with like Barbies as a kid?
I used to love to order them. It was so
I'm trying to be happy for you. It's just like I was by myself and like all these
good.
Yeah.
Okay. I just was afraid that you did want us to get killed today.
No.
It sounds like you're just kind of, tough time.
I'm kind of resigned to it, you know? That one kid, she's just brutal.
She is,
she
yeah.
She really likes to do it all to you, too. I don't understand.
Yeah.
Do you want, like, a group hug?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Pasta or Luca.
We love you. We hope you don't die.
Yeah, I feel better.
Yes.
Thanks, Barbie. Thanks, Skipper. Thanks, Teresa.
Welcome, Ken. Rosie, you look like crap.
This is getting out of hand.
Tabitha, I'm just saying.
Just because, okay, what does I'm just saying mean? People tack that onto things and it's like, the mirror of no offense, but.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just telling you that I'm just saying it. I'm not combining it with an action.
Just to make sure I understand, alternatively, you could have said I looked like crap and combined it with an action. So you wouldn't say I'm just saying, because you'd be I'm saying
and doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, so you're not going to say 100% unless you're like you've done mathematical calculations saying that you're 100% sure? That feels like a little extreme.
Yeah, no, I just like to be precise. And, I mean...
But, like, why do you have to call me out on it? Like, it's just, like, a figure of speech. Like, I don't have math for you.
Well, I didn't ask you to have math for me, Joseph. I was just saying.
In a lot of ways, it's not a free country. You can't just say, like, it's a free country, because it's like, is it?
Tabitha? Well, in many ways, it's a free country.
I did say literally, and no, there's not 10 million followers on my TikTok, but like, literally I'm famous and have 10,000 followers. It's like a common thing people say.
Like, it's not literal. It's just not. Like, it's, do you see?
Your 9,978 is like literally 10,000.
No, it's like almost 10,000.
No, it's literally like 10,000.
No.
This is like when you told me that I couldn't say.
Please stick around after that. and we will do exactly that right here on this stage. But for now, are you guys ready for your next act?
Yes!
Please welcome the final Meryl Streep performance of this calendar year. Give all your love to Vendetta!
Hello, we are Vendetta. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. All we need to get started from you all is a word. Any word?
Caffeine.
Caffeine. Thank you.
So I really like coffee, and I think I've got my coffee consumption at like a pretty okay level. That being said, I do get angry if I don't have it in the morning, so my husband might disagree with me about whether or not it's like the ideal level. But I have a 3-year-old son, and I'm worried I'm like starting him off on like the path of coffee, because he comes and he stands next to me while I make the coffee and he asks to smell it. And I let him, because why not? I'm like, it's just a smell. And then I'm like, this is how it starts. Like, he does not need caffeine, but I'm definitely getting like very close to being like let down a slippery slope to giving my 3-year-old caffeine. Caffeine makes me think of how, you know how like every 10 years the entire human theory of like what is like healthful eating like completely reverses itself? So like when I was a kid, I was part of like the Snackwells era, and everything was like, oh, like low cal, and like caffeine-free soda was felt to be like the nay plus ultra of like healthful drinking. It was like NutraSweet or whatever, like cholesterol, but fine, but the caffeine, like that's the thing that's gonna get you. And so I enjoy like living with my mom through these journeys, and the fact like my mom like disavows the fact that we ever took part in this like deeply unhealthful eating like at various points. But my mom was like an Atkins devotee at a very time. And I talk about this and I'm like, you know, bacon is not actually a health food. She's like, I don't know what you're talking about. And so it's like there's like this like collective amnesia that we ever participated in any of these like prior eating styles, but like I know, I remember.
My body is basically impervious to what I put into it. If I drink caffeine, I can fall asleep instantly. If I eat sugar, I still feel fine. If I eat pizza for like a week, I still feel pretty fine, or Chinese food or anything. Which is like, maybe will change at some point as I get older, but for now, is really a detriment to my health, because I don't have to eat healthily to feel okay. I don't really have to exercise either. and then you get a body that makes it feel like not so good when you look in the mirror, but physically I feel fine.
The story about, JoJo's story about exposing her son to caffeine makes me think about when I was little, I refused to take naps at daycare, and I had to be like separated in a separate room from other children, because I would like try to wake them up with me. And this is like very much not my personality now, but my mom had to ask the daycare center to actually like separate me too and not let me take a nap, because apparently if I did like miraculously fall asleep because I was never tired, then I would like stay up all night and she would have to just like put me in the car and drive me around until I finally like passed out. So now though I realize like what a treasure I wasted. Like I would love to be able to take a nap in the afternoon now, but there's no patience for it now that I'm old one, so.
Soccer tryout energy bars.
I love any of them?
Mom.
That one has a number in it.
Mom, I think that just a bagel would be fine. Like, really.
Oh, no. Did I not forward you the blog post from moms.com about cars are bad? This is, well, I don't know what it is, but it's not cars. It's energy. In the form of a bar, and it's specifically formulated for junior high girls trying out for soccer.
I sort of feel like this is one of those moments that I'm going to look back on as like a moment where I became an adult because there's like a disconnect here that I'm not. I'm 13 and yet somehow I'm seeing what this is and you're not.
I hear you. I was waiting for this day to come. I also got the adult version of adult bars.
Lindsay, come in here, sweetie. Grandpa wants to show you something. Now, this is my favorite deck of playing cards. Don't they feel nice, sweetie?
They do.
I'm going to teach you Texas Hold'em for your fifth birthday.
I like the naked ladies on them, too.
Oh, so yeah, you and I are going to be a lot alike.
Like, really naughty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ways you get money involved.
I don't want to have any money.
That's okay, sweetie. We'll just play with your dad's ones for now.
Okay.
Maybe a few fives.
I have a steak quarter collection, too.
Oh, why don't you go fetch those? The important thing is that you're playing with something that means something to you.
Yeah, I'm still waiting for my own name. It's the only one I want to have.
Well, why don't you use Montana, because that's almost as rare. Now, when you're older like me, you're going to love to go to a casino.
Casino?
And just drop hundreds on a game.
Yes.
Casino, yes, sweetie.
Yeah.
You're catching on already. Okay. So pick up your card at W5. Don't you love the feel of them?
Slippery, kind of sticky.
Yeah.
So excited.
Okay, so just remember, you can't tell your dad about this.
Oh, no.
It's a little touchy about games.
Games, like in general? We play games and ladders.
Specifically ones where you have to wager and lose.
Oh. Okay.
That's
I don't plan to lose tonight, though.
That's exactly the right attitude. So, the way Texas Hold'em works is put down your best three cards.
Do I show that to you? Or?
No. You have to make a bet on what you think your best three cards are.
Okay. I'm
going to
put down this one because she has red hair and it reminds me of Ariel.
Yeah,
and
I always
love
red hair too.
And I'm going to put down this one because I don't know, I just like her smile. And I'm gonna put down this one because she has pretty hair too.
Okay, well unfortunately for you, I have three aces. So I'm gonna just take those state quarters. Okay, that's the first lesson.
I feel like maybe Grandpa, like you're trying to take advantage of the fact that I've never played this before.
No, sweetie, I never would. But remember, you always have to find your angle. Right now my angle is that I'm more experienced.
Okay, you cannot wake up the other children when they're sleeping.
Mm-hmm. You could just sort through those. Okay, documents that already have my signature to one side, documents that look like they might need my signature to the other side, and bills in the recycling.
Yeah, and once you've done those, we'll practice doing Mr. Corey's signature.
Mr. Corey,
why does this one say F-I-N-A-L space N-O-T-I-C-E?
Somebody was able to make heads and tails of that thing.
That is fantastic. You know, I'm thinking maybe you don't need to go back to school at all. Maybe you just stay here. You can answer the phone when someone calls. Perfect.
Actually, our receptionist, Julie, just left a few months ago. We haven't been able to replace her.
I'm going to listen to this voicemail really quick.
Go for it.
Wait, this is Bill.
I know, I can never work the voicemail.
It says that they're about to repossess the playground equipment.
You know what? That playground equipment's really unsafe anyway. It's not up to code, so that's fine.
But I think the kids love the merry-go-round. It says if you just pay the money you owe, they won't take the playground equipment.
I'm so glad you thought of that. Here, let me just log on to my computer here. Okay, do you see this online poker game? Okay, so Mr. Corey's been playing, and he does not know the rules of poker, okay? So you go ahead and just start playing.
It's a good lesson to learn.
Yeah. That's perfect. That's perfect.
I don't know. It feels like there has to be a different, more right feeling way.
Honey, welcome to adulthood. There isn't.
Yeah, I, you know, that was the lesson of me getting fired. from JK, right, is don't touch the money. But I guess we shouldn't have let your mom touch it either.
Yeah, it's ironic that the 13-year-old who has not yet taken algebra is somehow kind of the most on top of the finances here.
You know, sweetie, if you just want to take over the monthly checkbook perusal, I think your mother and I would both welcome that.
It's a little late for that, Bruce. We don't have anything in the bank.
Okay, remember, I've asked you to call me Dad.
Well, that requires a level of respect that I don't presently know.
Yeah, that was fair.
All right, come on, Dad. Maybe if you just talk some sense into Mom, you know? What are some, like, things that you feel like you could use to sway her?
Sex usually works.
Oh, so gross. So gross.
Maybe she'll just see reason if I explain that those energy bars are made out of pure, you know, grease and paint.
Yeah.
Because
I both caught fire earlier.
Yeah, no, it was actually me. I was doing an experiment, but they did catch fire when I lit them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know what? Hey, sweetie. Sweetie, can you come down from upstairs, please?
Oh, is this, are you guys having a big life talk? Because I just happened to grab the big life talk bar.
Oh my God, Mom.
You should have one. I think it'll make it go better.
Mom, these burst into flames.
Wait, what?
Yeah. Remember how you used to have a car?
You burned my product?
I was just testing it out.
You burned the product, Bruce?
I don't like to eat things that can go up in flames.
Look, it's my product. It's my name on the line for the golden spork of the moms.com nutrition sales wing.
Okay, maybe you should try the sex thing. I don't know. Dare you, sir? You disgust me!
I was trying to blend in, and perhaps the lack of folks around my age in this school is proof of systemic ageism.
Okay. I've seen the likes of this woke radicalism. It's an elementary school! Of course there aren't a lot of old people wandering around.
Listen, you might have a discrimination lawsuit on your hands unless we can work out an arrangement.
I don't like that tone.
There's a game going on in the teacher's lounge. I want a 30% cut.
You can't afford the vig of that game.
I know a lot about a vig. And, oh, here they are now.
Look. I think there's a way we can all profit from this situation.
Well, Miss Anderson, please do enlighten us.
I think those other teachers have Christmas bonuses coming.
What school district are we going to? Oh my God, he needs some nourishment. Hurry, hurry, hurry! When was the last time you ate?
I was just trying to take a nap.
Oh, your body looks like it's withering away. I just naturally assumed there was like a starvation thing.
That one girl keeps waking us all up. Oh. So I get so tired I just fall asleep anywhere.
Look, at first I was just waking you up for fun because I was bored because I'm so advanced, but now I'm waking you up because I need help managing this place. The refrigerators are empty. There are no pouches. Zero pouches.
Wait. This is what adulthood is. It's just one problem after another problem after another problem. Then you just say, well, things will calm down at the end of next week. Every week until you die.
Help me. Help me place a bulk order from Costco.
He's clearly amazing.
I was having a dream about Barney.
We all gotta pull together. She doesn't know what she's doing. And Mr. Corey got fired for money laundering.
He can't stand. These legs are clearly decorative.
I can stand just.
Oh my God! It's a miracle.
I guess I'm a little confused because I was mid-ramp.
Mom, we've invited noted
motivational speaker, Glennon Doyle, to come and speak to you now. Glennon, if you could just talk to my mom.
Hey, what? No, I was told I was taking over the junior high girls soccer team, and that I was welcome to ply them with whatever products I had, whether or not they were FDA approved.
The thing about my marriage to Abby is that I don't feel a need to succumb to like mass produced products. Mm-hmm. All we need is love and green juice and a solid dose of parenting love.
Oh no. Glennon. No.
This is a green juice replacement bar.
Oh, there's spirulina in it.
I can pronounce that. Spirulina.
Now, is this something that I could sell to others?
No!
Or something that
that's a show!
Like I said, there will be a jam here, right in this space, in like 2 or 3 minutes. So if you want to play around, stay put, and we'll start that in a couple minutes. If you're done with Herald Night, thank you so much for coming out, and have a wonderful holiday season and a happy new year. And we'll be back here the first week of January for new Herald Nights. Good night.
It's a lifelong first.
So this will always be my email.